हेलो एवरीवन, अगेन टुडे वी आर रीडिंग चैप्टर 4, थिंकर बिलीफ एंड बिल्डिंग्स. सो हियर आई वांट टू टेल यू अबाउट बिल्डिंग्स एंड महावीरास. सो सम ऑफ द थिंकर इंक्लूड महावीर एंड बुद्धा रेज्ड क्वेश्चन अबाउट द अथॉरिटी ऑफ वेदास. दे ऑल्सो सजेस्ट दैट मेन एंड वुमेन themselves could try to attain liberation from the trials and tribulations of the worldly existence. The basic philosophy of Jainism already existed in North India. Even before the birth of Vardhaman Mahavira, the Mahavira's real name Vardhaman Mahavira. So even before the birth of Vardhaman Mahavira, it was existed. So according to Jain tradition, there were 23 teachers even before Mahavira who were known as Tirthankaras. If we ask the question who were Tirthankaras, then you can say that teacher and preacher in Jainism is called a Tirthankara. Those who existed before Vardhaman Mahavira. Is that clear? So most important idea of Jainism is that, the idea of Jainism that whole world is animated. It has been assumed that life exists even in stone, rocks and waters. Life exists even stone, rocks and water. Non-violence towards living beings, including human, animal, plants and insect, in central point of Jain philosophy. Jainism spread to the different parts of India, like the Buddhist Jaina scholar also produced great literature in different languages, like Prakrit, Sanskrit and Tamil. Buddha was most influential teacher of his time. In their time, Buddha was very influential teacher over there. During hundreds of years, his messages spread across the subcontinent and beyond, through Central Asia to China, Korea and Japan, through Sri Lanka, across sea to Myanmar, Thailand and Indonesia. So Buddha's childhood name was Siddhartha. He was son of chief of Shakya clan. He was the chief of Shakya clan's son. So Buddha was of opinion that society is not made by any spiritual supernatural power, but by human themselves. He advised the king and Grihapati to be humane and ethical. So according to Buddha, social relation could be transformed with individual efforts. Disciple of Buddha, disciple mean to say puppet. Disciple of Buddha soon increased in great existence. That's why he founded a Sangha. That's why they founded a Sangha. It was an institution of those monks who become teacher of Dhamma. He was the institution of those monks who became teacher of Dhamma. So these monks live in simple life. Initially only male were allowed in Sangha, but later on female were also permitted. According to Buddhist text, Ananda, the most dearest disciple of Buddha. According to text, Ananda, the most dearest disciple of Buddha, convinced him and made the entry of female possible into the Sangha. Buddha's disciple belong to many social groups. His disciples belongs to many social groups. They included king, wealthy person, grihapati and common masses like workers, slaves, craftsmen. All were regarded equal because all had to shed their earlier social identities on the becoming bhikkhus and bhikkhunis. They were not called them king and slaves and all. They shed that identities. They always called like bhikkhus and bhikkhunis. Is that clear? So listen this video carefully and again try to make the question answers. Have a good day.